Hi, my name is Erwin Wils. I'm a mindset coach and business strategist at Millionaire Life Strategy. And today I would like to share with you five things you need to know to create a highly successful private practice. And let's get right on with it with tip one. Shrink your niche. Now, what do we mean with that? Well, you just finished your training on hypnotherapy, NLP, coaching, whatever therapy. You've got the tools and skills to help everybody. But if you want to help everybody, you're actually helping nobody, because why should people come to you? So by shrinking your niche, you give people a reason to come to you. Let me give you an example. Let's take three physiotherapists. They're specialized in lower back pain. And the first one, his message is, do you suffer from lower back pain? Come to me. I will help you get rid of it. I'm the expert. The second one says, are you a bricklayer and you suffer from lower back pain? I'm the specialist. You have to see me. I will help you get rid of it. And the third one says, are you a bricklayer over 55 years old and you suffer from lower back pain? I'm the man. You have to see me. I help you get rid of it. Now, which of those three is the real expert? It's obviously, it's a third one. Because being a bricklayer, it's a tough job. You sit on your knees a lot, bend over. So having low back pain issues seems like part of the job. When you're over 55 years old, you've probably been a bricklayer all your life. So chances are your lower back it's worn out. So when you suffer from lower back pain, you're bricklaying over 55 years old, and you can help them get rid of it, you must be the expert. Let's assume I'm a bricklayer. I'm 25 years old and I suffer from a lower back. You know, I start feeling my lower back. I would call a third one because I don't want to wait another 30 years before he can help me. You know, my lower back might be worn out. And of course he will help me. Or let's say that I'm an office worker. I start feeling my lower back. I start searching for an expert and I see this third physiotherapist. I would call him as well, because if he can help bricklayers get rid of the lower back pain, mine should be a piece of cake. And of course, he will help me. So try to find your own niche. The more specific, the better it is. Let's put it in a metaphor. If you go to fish, do you want to fish in a small pond and catch every fish in it? Or do you want to fish in the ocean, hoping one will bite? And please remember, there's a difference between your marketing message and the people you actually help. Even though I specialize in empowering technical experts, people still come to me for hypnotherapy. And of course I will help them, but that's not my focus in my marketing message. The second tip I would like to share with you, it's sell the end result. A lot of people are focusing on the tools, but the client isn't interested in the tool or the process. They're interested in the end result. What will it give them? When I started my first coaching sessions, I sold a coaching program for 10,000 euros for 6 months. And I would help people get rid of their limiting beliefs, you know, find their inner talents, boost their self-confidence, make them at ease with public speaking. I would create the version 2.0 of my clients. But for my clients, it's actually hard to see the end result. So they don't know if it's worth the 10K investment. And I had to sell the end result. That was a game changer for me. So let's say that you're making 50K a year and I would coach you for 6 months. And after this 6 months of coaching, you would make 75K. So an additional 25K of income. Then an investment of 10K would make perfectly sense. And the fun part is, it doesn't even matter what time it takes. Or even better, the shorter the time it takes, the better it is. If I could coach you for 2 hours, that you would be able to make an additional 25k after that, you wouldn't bother paying the 10k for that because you would earn it back in no time. So sell the end result. With regard to my coaching program, what I need to give my clients might still be working on the limiting beliefs, find their inner talents, have them feel at ease when they have to speak in public. Maybe I have to boost the self-confidence. So the coaching can still be the same, but now it's in service. It's to support the end result they want to achieve. Let me give you another example. Let's take two Apple iPods in the advertisement. The first one states 4 gigabytes internal memory. The other one states 200 hours music in your back pocket. What do you think the customer is looking for? Of course, they're looking for 200 hours of music. And the 4 gigabytes internal memory is the tool to make that happen. So don't sell the tool, sell the end result. The third tip I would like to share with you is it's not about you. And that's especially with regard to pricing. A lot of starting therapists and coaches have a hard time deciding what to ask for the services. Because let's say in hypnotherapist, you know, they can do a session in 1 hour and they feel bad asking 200 euros for that. Because who's going to pay them 200 euros for just 1 hour of work? That seems outrageous. That's what lawyers ask, not a hypnotherapist. But the client is not paying for you. They're paying for the end result. Now, if you go out for dinner with the two of you, between 50 and 100 euros, you spend easily. Well, you want to buy brand jeans or shoes or boots. The pricing starts at 100 euros. They go to 200, 500, even 800, 1,000 euros. And you have the skills and tools to help somebody that has been living with a fear or phobia for 5, 10, 20, who knows how many years, to have them get rid of this fear or phobia in one session. What's it worth to them? And that's the price you can ask. But they're not paying for you, they're paying for the end result. Just remember that. The third tip I would like to share, the fourth tip already, is give this temporary discounts. And this will probably be giving me a lot of comments, because a lot of gurus and other coaches out there, they say, you should never give discounts. You know, you're doing yourself a disservice. You're worth the price you're asking. You can give them additional things, but never give discounts. And the funny part, if you look at it, most of them sell a program that's too good to be true. You know, they're giving you this temporary time to buy it, and it's only for this price, otherwise the price will go up. So what are they doing? They're actually giving a discount. But the reason I'm saying giving this temporary discounts, because when you have a new service or product you would like to introduce, have two prices in mind. The price you would really like to ask for your service and the price you feel comfortable asking. So let's take my coaching program of 10K again. And I feel I truly want to ask it, but I don't feel comfortable asking for it. But I feel totally comfortable asking 2,000 euros for that 6-month program. Because I will put in the time, the effort, I know my clients will benefit from it, and I have no issues asking 2,000 euros for my coaching program. Then it's all about framing. Because I could say, you know, let's say that you approach me for the coaching program, and I would say to you, okay, my coaching program normally is asking for an investment of 10,000 euros, but you're in a new market for me. I've never coached anybody in this market. I want to validate my coaching program, if it will work as effectively in this market as it does in other markets. So So I would really love for you to be one of my first pilot clients. I'm looking for 5, and I really want you to be one of those. And if you want to be one of my pilot clients, I will give you a massive discount of 80%. So I'm not asking those 10K of you, but I'll ask for an investment of 2,000 euros. And you take me up on the offer. I will coach you for half a year. And after the 6 months, you're enthused, you know, it was great. You've made changes, transformations you couldn't have imagined before. And you tell it to a friend, and a friend comes to me and he says, you did such a great job. I want the same program. And I would say to that friend, okay, well, normally my price for this program is 10,000 euros. But because you came to me, you know, I didn't do any marketing and you're already showing your trust in the program because you've talked to your friend. I want to give you a great deal. I'm not asking for this 10,000 euros investment. I'm asking 4,000 euros. So I'll give you a 60% discount. How about that? Just to reward you for the fact that you came to me. And 9 out of 10 times they will take it. And if they would ask, you know, but why did my friend only pay 2,000 euros for the same program and I have to pay 4? And I can honestly say, well, because he was one of my 5 pilot clients to validate the program. And I gave him this massive discount of 8,000 euros. And there were some requirements about around that. But I've tested the program, I validated, you've seen the results, so I know it's working. So it should actually ask the full price. But I want to approach you, I want to help you. So I'm giving you a 60% discount. End of discussion. He will be happy. I'm happy. But I just doubled my price. I went from 2,000 euros to 4,000 euros. So that's the first benefit of giving this temporary discounts. The second benefit is you start getting used asking 10,000 euros for my coaching program. And the moment I forget to give a discount, I'm asking full price and I feel totally comfortable asking that. The third benefit is the perceived value, because the client receives a coaching program that's worth 10,000 euros and has only paid 2,000 or 4,000. So the perceived value is higher. It's like you're buying a Ferrari and you're only paying for a Volkswagen. And the fourth benefit, if you give such a massive discount, you can ask something in return. So for instance, you know, if you're willing to work with me, I'm giving you the discount, but when you're happy with the end result, when you're satisfied, I would like to get a video testimonial from you. Or I would like to have an introduction to 4 of your friends that might benefit from this service as well, from this program as well, just for a free discovery call to see if there's a fit. So you can ask something in return for that. And that's a great way to start introducing your new service or new product. Just make sure that you frame it correctly. And the fifth and final benefit I would like to share with you, don't call yourself a starter. The moment you start, you're a starter. A day later, you're already on the market. When you call yourself a starter or new coach or new therapist, then you're doing yourself a disservice. You're actually giving yourself less credit than you're worth. Because you're actually saying to your client, I'm not sure if I will get the end result for you because I just started. I'm new to this. There are other coaches, other therapists out there that have got much more experience and skills maybe, you know. I'm new. It's like you're telling them they are your first client. But just remember that even though you just started your practice, you're the result of your life experience. You've been walking on this earth for a long time. You've gained your tools, your skills, your experience. And this training is like the icing on the cake, you know, where everything comes together. So you might be new as a therapist, but you're not a starter yourself. Because all your life experience builds up in the person that you are at that moment. So just say that you're a therapist or a coach. Don't say that you're new. You might be new to the market, but as a person, you've been there a lifetime. So don't forget that. And if I can give you one bonus tip, and you might have heard it through this little video. When people want to do business with you, tell them it's an investment they're making. When they're not willing to do business with you, you start talking about costs. Because costs are out-of-pocket money. It's gone. You don't get anything in return. If you're talking about an investment, there's a return for that. That's why they call it an ROI, a return on investment. So if they're spending money with you, it's an investment for them. When they're not decide to do business with you, you can talk about costs. Now, what will it cost you if you do it on your own? What are the costs? Or what are you spending when you do try to find it, figure it out all by yourself? How many years would you like to walk with this phobia of fear? You know, you've already had this for so many years. Do you think you can get rid of it by yourself? But for a small investment of X amount of money, I can help you one, maybe two sessions, and it's gone. Do you feel the difference? So that's it for now. I hope you find some inspiration in this little video. And if you want to like to explore what I can mean to you, if I can help you or coach you or whatever, just approach me on a free discovery call. You can find it on my website, millionairelifestrategy.com, or connect with me on LinkedIn. You'll find me there. Thanks for watching and good luck with your business. And don't forget to have fun. Bye.